How's everyone doing today? I'm Jess, your anchor for today's story, and I hope you all are doing well.
Send me your location, let's focus on communicating, cause I just need the time and place to come through.
Today's topic is a really, really important topic that we must discuss. We absolutely must discuss it. So if you have not subscribed to the channel, click the subscribe button below and let's get into today's topic. On February 17th, 2022, WNBA star Brittney Griner was arrested. Many of you may have heard this, on drug charges in Russia. She was detained at the international airport in Russia. And they detained her because they found in her suitcase that she was carrying a vaporized cartridge that contained hash oil, which is an illegal substance in Russia. Some U.S. officials actually have expressed concern that Russia may be using Brittney Griner as leverage in response to the Western sanctions that have been imposed against Russia on February 12th for the Russian invasion of the Ukraine. And she's been deemed a high profile hostage for Russia. And it was July 7th that Brittney Griner actually pled guilty to the charges against her, but she said that she did not intentionally break the law prohibiting the contraband. This brings us to an important conversation that we need to have regarding travel. And some of y'all, and I say some, but some of y'all doing whatever the hell you want to do when you leave the borders of the United States. When you travel internationally, you must understand that being an American in some countries can work against you. And in Brittney Griner's case, they detained her as a result of her being in possession of what that country, the country of Russia, deems to be an illegal substance. She is not the first Black celebrity to be arrested and detained. Many of you may remember that ASAP Rocky was detained, I believe, in Sweden, and he was arrested in Stockholm because he was punching and kicking some man on the street. And, you know, there are many important lessons in this story, but I want to highlight a couple. The most important lesson that I believe we can glean from this story is that those of you who enjoy the assistance, the support, or fall under the influence of what I will call Mary 420, okay? And I say Mary 420 because I have to be careful what I say on the platform. But the point is, you really need to leave that kind of contraband in the comfort of your own home. You take risk packing these Mary 420 infused edibles. You take risk by packing the vape pens, which regardless of what's in the vape pens, you know, in some countries, just that alone is deemed to be illegal. Having it in your possession is considered illegal. Shout out to the United Arab Emirates because e-cigarettes are illegal in the UAE. So don't even try it. And there are so many random laws that we don't even know about here in the United States, let alone when you go abroad. And some of these countries can choose to enforce what they want, when they want, for whatever purposes they want. You know, and there's a history of Americans being detained overseas. So don't think just because you don't hear about this on television that somehow it's not happening, because that's just not true. In 2010 alone, there were about 3,500 Americans who were arrested abroad. And not all of these Americans have been released. even when it comes to Brittney Griner, she could be facing 10 years in a Russian prison for this action of just having this contraband. And many actually speculate that part of the reason why she pled guilty was so that they can begin the process of negotiating to get her back home to the United States. And so this is a serious issue. We have Americans who are doing some serious time in foreign prisons. Which brings me to the second point I want to make, which is do not go over to some of these countries being rude, disrespectful, and insulting these people's countries. You know, I've seen Americans having meltdowns overseas, going off on people. One lady who could actually never be a part of another trip that we put together ended up arguing with this man about the price she wanted to pay to buy his merchandise. And the woman got so upset that she destroyed some of this man's products. Not only is that a bad look for Americans, but she could have gotten arrested. So we don't want to do all that. That's why we try to be very selective about the travelers who are allowed to travel with us. You know, we don't want to do all of that. That's doing way too much. And so I encourage all of you, when you're traveling abroad, check your attitude at the custom gate of the country you're about to enter into. You know, I remember many, many years ago witnessing a domestic violence situation abroad, and I was about to jump in because I was like, I'm not about to sit back and let this woman catch a beat down. But I was actually advised to stay out of it, and I was reminded that I was in a different country, and those instincts to jump in and get involved could actually have done more harm to me than the guilty party. We must remember that domestic violence is not viewed the same in every country. Some countries, domestic violence is permissible when it comes to a man, you know, putting hands on a woman. It's like not a big deal. It just depends on the country you're in. And so you have to always be mindful that some of the things that you would not think would be a crime, when you're traveling abroad, some of these places, you just never know what the laws are. So you just have to be aware. But here is some really important information that you should know just in case you get caught up in a situation or someone you know gets caught up in a situation overseas and somehow you are detained or arrested. If you are arrested overseas, immediately ask to speak to a consular office at the nearest U.S. embassy or consulate. Under international agreements, the United States government has the right to provide consular assistance to you upon your request. And if you request to speak to a consul, if your request to speak to a consul is turned down, keep asking politely but persistently. In case you are or someone you know is arrested overseas, ask the prison authorities to notify the United States Embassy or Consulate, and you should also reach out to the closest United States Embassy or Consulate to let them know of your arrest. When a U.S. citizen is arrested overseas, he or she may actually be initially confused and disoriented, mainly because there's no way to know every single law in every single country. It's just not possible. But, you know, people may be unfamiliar with their surroundings and may not know the local language or customs, or especially their legal system. And there are a number of things the United States can do in the event you were to get incarcerated overseas. And if you are on our mailing list, you will receive an email that shares that list of the assistance the United States can help you with. However, there's a lot the United States cannot do for you as well. So be mindful. The United States cannot get a U.S. citizen out of jail in a foreign prison. The United States cannot speak to your guilt or innocence to a court. They can't do that. They also cannot provide legal advice. They cannot provide representation to U.S. citizens in court. They cannot serve as an official interpreter or a translator. And they will not pay your legal, medical, or other fees. So you want to be very clear that there are limitations to what the United States can do if you get caught up in another country's system. Just understand, before you leave the country, be on your best behavior. Leave the Mary 420 products and contrabands behind so you do not get caught up. And understand that the last thing you want to do is to get in a situation in another country that involves you having to go through their international court system or being taken to their jail or their prison. So be safe, ladies and gentlemen, and until next time.
Send me your location, let's focus on communicating, 'cause I just need the time and place to come through.